Hello and welcome to my video lecture series. Our topic for today is internal structure of human heart. Okay, so let's begin with it, friends. Just let us revise a few things regarding the external structure of a human heart. So the human heart is a four chambered heart. All right, so I think everybody knows that there are two atria which are present. All right, the left and the right atria, and there are two ventricles that are present. All right, again the left and the right. Okay, the right side of the heart is concerned with transport of deoxygenated blood, whereas the left side is concerned with the transport of oxygenated blood. So if I draw a simple diagram over here, suppose that this is the heart, all right, and these are the four chambers. This is the right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. Then the portion which I am going to shade with a yellow color is concerned with deoxygenated blood. Okay, whereas the portion that I am going to shade with green color is concerned with oxygenated blood. Okay, so what happens exactly is, just to summarize what we have learned in that last video lecture, is the right atrium receives deoxygenated blood. Okay, it receives deoxygenated blood from blood vessels which are called as vena cava. Okay, there is a superior vena cava and there is an inferior vena cava. All right, so the vena cava is somewhat like this vessel. Okay, so this is the superior vena cava, this is the inferior vena cava. Both of them open into the right atrium. Okay, both the vessels bring deoxygenated blood from the body. All right, and there are vessels which are called as coronary sinus. So coronary sinus is nothing but a collection of coronary veins. Okay, and what do coronary veins do? Yes, you're correct. They basically bring the deoxygenated blood from the heart into the right atrium. So all the blood vessels bringing deoxygenated blood open into the right atrium, that is this portion, correct? Then the blood flows from the right atrium into the right ventricle. Then from the right ventricle, it goes to the lungs. So it goes to the lungs through a blood vessel called as the pulmonary trunk. All right. So if I have to draw the pulmonary trunk, suppose if I use this blue color, then it will open from the right ventricle, all right, and this is the pulmonary trunk, all right, this shaded area, all right, and then it bifurcates into two branches which are called as the pulmonary artery. So before the bifurcation, that vessel is called as the pulmonary trunk, and the bifurcation is called as pulmonary artery. So this is the left pulmonary artery, right. Each pulmonary artery will enter the lung on its side. So that is about the pulmonary trunk. Okay, so pulmonary trunk branches into the left and right pulmonary artery. Okay, they will take the deoxygenated blood into the lungs, all right, and from the lungs the oxygenated blood will enter the left atrium. So I'm going to show that vessel with the red color. So the blood will come in through vessels which are called as pulmonary veins. So there are four outlets, okay, two from the left side and two enter from the right side. So I'm going to draw these two. Now these two are not opening into the right atrium, they're basically going from the back side and entering into the left atrium. So these four pulmonary veins will basically open into the left atrium. They will bring the oxygenated blood from the lungs into the left atrium. Okay, then what will happen? From the left atrium, the oxygenated blood will go into the left ventricle, and from the ventricle they will go into the largest artery of the body, which is called as the aorta. Okay, so this is the aorta, and aorta supplies oxygenated blood to all the parts of the body. Now, the heart receives deoxygenated blood from an artery called as the coronary artery. Coronary artery also opens from the left ventricle and it goes into the heart. So that is about the external structure that we have seen. Now, one more thing that we had learned in the external structure is that there are walls present or there are septa present between the four chambers of the heart. Okay, the one present between the two atriums is called as interatrial septum. Alright, the one present between the two ventricles is called as interventricular septum. Septa or septum means wall, and the one present between atrium and ventricle is called as atrioventricular. So this is atrioventricular, this is also atrioventricular. So these are the three types of septa or walls present. Alright. And one more thing that we had learnt in the external structure was that in the fetus there is a connection between the pulmonary trunk and the aorta. Alright. So what used to happen is in the fetus, or what happens is there is this connection which is present. Okay. And that connection is called as, anybody remembers the name? So it is called as conus arteriosus. Okay, so conus arteriosus is basically the structure which connects the pulmonary trunk to the aorta. So mixing of blood occurs, but this happens in the fetus. Okay, and this conus arteriosus is replaced in the adults. Okay, so these are the things that we had learned in the external structure of the heart. This is just a summary. I would request all of you who have not seen the previous video to go and check that out and then continue with the internal structure. Alright, now let us start with the internal structure of the heart. Okay, so what are the things that we are going to learn in the internal structure of the heart? So let us have a look at the diagram. Here is the diagram of the internal structure. Okay, now this area is obviously the left atrium. This is the left ventricle, sorry, this is the right atrium, this is the right ventricle, and this is the left ventricle. So four chambers. Okay, now this is the cross section of the heart showing the internal chambers. Here the purple blood vessel that I have shown over here and here, this is the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava. All right I would like to add something over here. Now basically the internal structure of the heart basically shows different types of valves. Okay, so what are valves? Valves are the structure which prevent the backflow of blood. Clear? Now these valves are basically present in the blood vessels, and they are also present in the chambers of the heart as well. Okay, so first let us have a look at the valves which are present in the blood vessels. So this is the superior vena cava. This is the inferior vena cava. As you notice, the blood is flowing in the upward direction against gravity. So there is a valve present over here, which is called as Thebesian valve. Okay, so I'm going to write down inferior vena cava over here, and I'm going to write down the name of the valve called as Thebesian valve. Oh, I'm actually really sorry, it's not called as Thebesian valve, it's called as Eustachian valve. So I will write down the name. So Eustachian valve is the valve which is present in the inferior vena cava. The superior vena cava doesn't require a valve. Now the next valve that we are going to study is present in the pulmonary trunk. As you see, this is the pulmonary trunk, it opens into the right ventricle. So this valve that you see, that is basically called as a semilunar valve. So I'm going to write down pulmonary trunk over here, and the valve which is present is called as a semilunar valve. Now the valve, the cross section of the valve appears like a half moon, that is why it is called as semilunar. So this is a semilunar valve. Similarly, aorta is probably one of those arteries which has a valve. Normally arteries do not have a valve, but aorta has a valve, and again this valve that you see is also called as a semilunar valve. So semilunar valves are present in both the pulmonary trunk as well as the aorta. So I am going to write down pulmonary trunk as well as aorta. It is also called as the systemic aorta. Correct? They both have the semilunar valves. So right now we have studied three valves in the blood vessel. Okay, this one is the Eustachian valve, this is the semilunar, this is the semilunar. Now there is one more valve present in the blood vessel, and it is present in the coronary sinus. So what is coronary sinus? Coronary sinus is basically the group of coronary veins which are present, and these also have a valve which is called as Thebesian valve. Alright, so earlier I had said that Thebesian valve is present in inferior vena cava, but it is actually present in the coronary sinus. So once again, the four valves present inside the blood vessels surrounding the heart: semilunar valve, Eustachian valve, and the coronary sinus, which is present behind on the dorsal surface, has the Thebesian valve. Okay, so Eustachian, Thebesian at the back, semilunar, semilunar. Is this clear? Okay, so that is about the valves. So Eustachian valve, inferior vena cava, Thebesian valve, coronary sinus, pulmonary trunk, and aorta have semilunar valves. So how many valves do we study over here in the vessels? Total four valves. So there are many more valves present, but this is related to the heart. So four valves, right? Now let us study the different valves of the heart. There are two main valves of the heart. Okay, one is called as the tricuspid valve, and the other one is called as the bicuspid valve. All right, the bicuspid valve is also called as the mitral valve. Now, where are these valves present? So again, let us have a look at this diagram. The valve present on the interatrioventricular septum between the right atrium and right ventricle, this is the septum, this is the valve. So this is called as the tricuspid valve. So tricuspid valve is present between the right atrium and ventricle. All right. This, the bicuspid valve is present between the left atrium and ventricle. So that's it, two valves in the heart, easy. Now, why are these valves called as cuspid? Again, if you look at the cross section, then this is the cross section of the valve. It will show three cusps. First cusp, second cusp, third cusp. Whereas a bicuspid valve shows just two cusps, one and two. So that is how the valves open. So that is the cusp. So that is the bicuspid valve and tricuspid valve. You must be really very curious to know what is the meaning of mitral valve. Now, mitre is a type of the hat which the Pope wears. So even a mitre has a double folding similar to this. That is why it is also called as the mitral valve. Okay. So that is why the name. Okay. So once again, the six different valves: Eustachian valve, Thebesian at the coronary sinus, this semilunar, semilunar valve, tricuspid valve, bicuspid valve. Alright. Now, what are these green things that I have shown? Now, these are basically the muscles, or you can say the connective tissue which is present inside the ventricles. Both the ventricles are that. And the function of these connective tissue is to basically hold the valves in the downward direction. So what exactly happens is, when the ventricle undergoes systole, or when it undergoes contraction, the blood will obviously flow to the pulmonary trunk, but because of the contraction, there is a chance that this valve might become upside down. So to prevent that, these structures are present which hold the valve in the downward direction. They are called as chordae tendinae. Alright? Okay? So there are chordae tendinae present inside the ventricles, right ventricle as well as the left ventricle. They hold the valves in a proper position and they prevent them from flipping in the opposite direction. Okay. So when will this valve open? When the atria contracts, when the right atrium contracts, the tricuspid valve will open. So it will allow the blood to flow from the atrium, right atrium, to the right ventricle. As it flows into the right ventricle, this valve will close. So when this contracts, there will be no backflow of blood into the right atrium. It will all pass into the pulmonary trunk. As the blood enters the pulmonary trunk, the semilunar valves will open to allow the blood to pass through. But as soon as all the blood goes inside the trunk, these valves will close down to prevent the backflow. Similarly, the pulmonary veins will bring in the oxygenated blood. The oxygenated blood, when the atria contracts, the left atrium when it contracts, the bicuspid valve will open. It will allow the blood to pass through. When the left ventricle contracts, this will again shut down to prevent backflow. And similarly, when this contracts, the left ventricle, the blood will pass into the aorta, the semilunar valve will be open. The blood, once it enters the aorta, all the blood is entered, this will close down to prevent backflow. So that is how the valves work, they prevent the backflow of blood. Okay, so these are the things that we have learned about the valves, six different valves related to the heart and the blood vessels connecting the heart. Now we have a look at some of the specialized structures over here. There is a structure present inside the right atrium, this structure, and it is called as fossa ovalis. So basically fossa ovalis is a connection present in the fetal heart. So what happens is, in the fetal heart, the left atrium and the right atrium are basically interconnected. So there is a pathway which connects both the chambers. Normally in an adult human being, the connection, no direct connection is there between the atria. However, in a fetal heart it is there, and that fossa or that opening is called as fossa ovalis. Now the fossa ovalis present in adults is obviously a remnant. The fossa is completely sealed, so there is no more connection, but you can obviously, when you cut open the heart, you can see that the fossa ovalis was present during some point of time. Okay. Then ligamentum arteriosum we have already seen. So this is basically in the external structure of the heart. This has nothing to do in the internal structure. So that is in the external structure. Then you know about the pulmonary veins. They bring in the oxygenated blood from the lungs. There are two pairs. Okay. Now coming back to the ventricles. Now the ventricles are lined by irregular muscles, the one shown in orange over here. And the ventricles are lined by muscles called as papillary muscles. Do you get me? Okay. And the lining of the ventricles is also irregular. Okay. And the lining is basically made up of something called as columnae carnae. So I have labeled it over here, the columnae or trabeculae carnae. This is a E over here. So that is the lining of the ventricle, which is irregular. The muscles surrounding the ventricle are called as papillary muscles. One thing that you have to know is the wall, the muscles of the left ventricle are much more thicker compared to the right ventricle, because this part has to do the pumping part to all the body parts. So all the blood, oxygenated blood, will be pumped by the left ventricle. So wall, the muscles of the left ventricle are much more thicker compared to the right ventricle. And size wise, the right atrium is slightly bigger compared to the left atrium. Alright, so that is it about the internal structure of the heart. So if I have to make a summary about the internal structure, these are the things that I will write down. First of all, I will write about the valves. Which are the valves present? The semilunar valve, which are present in the blood vessels. Alright, then there is the valve which is called as Eustachian valve, present in the inferior vena cava. There is the Thebesian valve, present in the coronary sinus. Okay, these are the valves of the blood vessels. Then come the valves of the heart. There are two main types: tricuspid valve, present between the right atrium and ventricle, and then there is the bicuspid valve, present between the left atrium and ventricle, which is also called as a mitral valve. Alright, then there is a specialized structure called as the fossa ovalis. Now it is just the remnant of the original one, it is completely sealed. It basically was a path through which the right atrium and left atrium were connected, sealed in, added, so fossa ovalis. Then the ventricles are lined by muscles called as papillary muscles, and the surface of the ventricles is made up of columnae or trabeculae carnae. Is it okay? Cool? Alright, so I think that are the different new things that we have learned, and I forgot about chordate tendineae. So chordate tendineae are basically part of the tissue which hold both the tricuspid and the bicuspid valve in their position. They prevent the flipping of the valves. Okay, so the chordate tendineae is basically attached to the papillary muscles. As you can see in this diagram, the chordate tendineae are attached to the muscles over here. So that is about the anatomy of the internal structure of heart. Okay, so that is it regarding the internal structure. I hope you have understood this. Thanks a lot for listening patiently.